So, hello everyone. During these unprecedented times, we do have to take drastic measures to ensure that learning does take place and does not stop. Today we have two students, Shreya and Abhishan, who will be giving their testimony or personal experience on e-learning and online teaching. So I have a few questions for you guys. So let's start off. My first question is, what are the advantages of e-learning or online teaching according to you? So Shreya, let's start off with you first.
During this pandemic issue, online learning has effectively allowed us to continue learning while staying safe at home. Due to virtual media, I'm learning new technological mediums like the Padlet website, in which class discussions are occurring more frequently and more efficiently. And homework assignments have been assigned through Google Classroom, and I'm able to get alerts, which allows me to complete my assignments on time as well.
So apart from the one Shreya had mentioned, personally, as an individual and society student, I feel that concepts could be explained much more easily through online classes, and especially in subjects like BNM, where we business management, where we recently did a topic called the decision tree. The use of an online whiteboard enabled us all to edit, and at the same time, letting the teacher help us simultaneously. Personally, I've done more class activities than during the normal school time, so that's one way advantages for me.
So yeah, since we know both of you have completely different subject choices, one of you has taken natural sciences while another has taken social sciences. What challenges as a learner did you face while transforming from conventional classrooms to online platforms?
Well, initially I had a few mild headaches as I've never sat continuously in front of my PC for this long a period of time. Moreover, IB is an experimental program where the first-hand experience of all those experiments is quite unique. And especially when it comes to natural sciences, and when we're learning through virtual media, all those first-hand experience has been lost, is what I think.
Exactly like Shreya mentioned, I had a few headaches in the start because of continuous exposure to so much PC. But then I had no problems others usually have, like no video connectivity issues or no Wi-Fi connectivity issues. But then initially I found it hard to connect to Discord, where our BNM classes are conducted. And it's my personal fault because I wasn't familiar on how to use Discord. But then apart from that, I'd like to highlight a problem with not us students face, but what teachers face. So they're not turning on video is a very serious issue, at least for teachers, because turning on video would make the teachers feel like they're actually at class and they can keep their personal touch going. So that's what I recommend.
So yes, as an individual or as a group school, what measures did you take to cope up with the challenges that you faced due to online platforms?
Firstly, I really would like to appreciate the school's effort in modifying our timetable suiting to our requirements based on our feedback. So actually, they have introduced a 10-minute break in between each of our classes, which has reduced our on-screen time and which has allowed us to relax a bit in between our classes. That has made my learning much more effective than before. And me personally, I have modified my personal timetable according to the switch in timetable or as per school. So that has allowed me to continue learning effectively during this pandemic issue as well.
I second Shreya's opinion, especially as she emphasizes on the 10-minute break and a more requirement-based timetable. But from my part, it's a very commendable effort from the teachers and especially the IT department from our school. That's all I have to say.
Thank you, Shreya and Abhishan, for your personal insights. And just to shortly conclude, I would like to say, yes, we do understand that there is a lack of personal touch and there are lots of practical difficulties that we face on online platforms. And in-person sessions prove to be more effective than detached clinical online platforms, as there is the essence of a student-teacher bond, which is crucial to schooling. However, we must understand that e-learning has become the new normal and therefore it comes with its own challenges. But it also has its own advantages. For example, everybody can have their own personalized schedule and it hones our independency skills and our time management skills. And each individual as an independent learner. Many teachers have unlearned their traditional methods and relearned new methods to ensure that learning is effective and exchange of information is seamless. So the ecosystem of effective learning and teaching is evolving. E-learning will be adaptive, evolving and skill-based. So my suggestion is we should stick to its strength, embrace the weaknesses and move forward. So thank you very much.